Hi, in this video I'll show you how to upgrade a MacBook. What I have is a MacBook with Snow Leopard, and now a lot of softwares are not supporting Snow Leopard. Snow Leopard is MacOS 10.6.8. For example, Chrome is displaying a message that's not supporting, it's no longer supporting macOS Snow Leopard. So then I'm going to install the latest possible operating system. So currently the macOS Sierra is the latest available version. But if you are running Snow Leopard, then you cannot upgrade to Sierra. So I saw here in the system requirement. So the way to upgrade is, I click on macOS Sierra. Okay. Then I say upgrade now. Okay. So probably I will say do nothing, because if I see the list of, so okay, go to more, and if I see list of supported operating systems for upgrade, how to upgrade in the technical specification. Okay, check your Mac hardware. So if I see here, MacBook 2009 or newer is supported. So definitely the MacBook I have is 2010 plus. So it will definitely be supported, but then going to the OS version, so update is probably not possible. So yeah, that's what I see, that from a version .6.8, this upgrade is not possible. Okay, so yeah, here is the compatibility information. So I see here from Lion onwards it is possible to upgrade. Snow Leopard is not supported, so I need to upgrade to 10.11 Al Capitan. So what I have done is I have gone to the Al Capitan site. So Al Capitan is available for the MacBooks which presently do not support upgrade to Sierra. So I have downloaded it. So what if it is not supported, so then there is a okay, so I've backup my files. Then I go to the Sierra page. So I don't do this because so I was able to get the link from Al Capitan. Can do a Google search. Okay, so okay, so then I go to system requirement. You see here, this is you know, the update of El Capitan is for OS which have I'll share the link from where I got the 6 GB download of macOS El Capitan. So here this is good information about how you can create the storage space. So yeah, from the App Store I was able to download El Capitan, and then here I have it downloaded. So I'm showing how the installation happens. Click continue. I have to agree the license agreement. I say agree, and it is asking, okay, do you want to install? So I say install. Okay, it's recommending that the hardware should connected to power source. So I'm switching on the power. Now it would be asking for your admin password. Okay, so the installation has begun. It is preparing to install. For taking a backup, you can use the time machine feature. You can backup your files to the cloud, iCloud. What I have done is I have used Seagate hard drive to backup my files. And this is based on NTFS. So I have to get a driver because by default, NTFS file systems can be read only in the MacBook for writing to the Seagate hard drive. You need a special driver, so that additional driver I have installed. And then once all the files are backup, I have initiated the download of macOS El Capitan from the App Store. I have to enter my credit card details, and around 60 rupees got deducted. I'm not sure whether I'll get the refund of these, but yeah, it was mentioned as a free update. Probably it's for the verification. You get some money deducted to your card. Now it has prepared for the installation. It's saying it is going to restart. I will click restart. Okay, so I say close other applications. It will close the other applications and will restart the MacBook. Okay, my other applications are closed. Okay, so it's preparing to restart. Okay, your computer is restarting. In this laptop, I have 2 GB RAM, 2 GHz of processor. Just waiting for it, the laptop to get restarted. So the system has shut down. Now it is starting again. And I see, okay, the update is in progress. Okay, so it has started the installation. It's saying around 31 minutes remaining. So the progress bar has reached to around 10% level. Okay. Shows the software which are incompatible, so it moves them to incompatible folder. Now it's setting up the MacBook. So I have already entered the username and password, so it has accepted the credential and it's taking it inside. And voila, this update has completed. So I see the desktop getting loaded. Shows a message about JDK needs to be installed. Say okay. Okay, so here is the new interface. Yes. So yeah, the Chrome has also been updated. Thank you.